Now, I've been wanting to try this beer. Originally, I thought it said tea, because I'm a big fan of tea in beer. But instead, it says TFA, which means totally ducking. Awesome. I'm not going to swear on the channel. Unless I've had too much to drink, then I'll all balls to the wall. I should also point out that I watched some videos and some for this brewery and stuff like that. They're massive Star Wars fans. So TFA could stand for The Force Awakens. But yeah. Now, this was recommended by Rob Derbyshire from Hopzine. I put his review in the description below. He likes to swear a lot. I think he got off saying the TFA a lot. But yeah, he said it's their best can yet. I've not had it. He purchased it via Trembling Madness in New York, if I recall. Because I asked him to pick it up for me because I could not find it. Because I wanted to try it. Black IPA was my favorite style probably of 2015. But yeah, it's like a hybrid of an oppy dark beer. But yeah. So anyway, moving on. Moor have made some other Star Wars kind of themed beers. They did the Empire Strikes Back and stuff like that. And I think I've watched a video at their tap or their brewery. They've actually got a lifelike Star Wars figures and stuff like that. It's put in black. I'm a big fan of their Smoky Horizon. But yeah. Brown chocolatey body. It's medium to small bubbles. Not much colour coming through the body. You get that almost like dark berry taste on the aroma. Slight chocolatiness, almost like a milky chocolate. But yeah, so it stands for totally awesome. Totally TFA. But yeah, and again, with this Star Wars theme, they see The Force Awakens is episode 7. And they've done a 7% beer. I'm a big fan of Moor beer cans. I always try and pick up some. Reliance, I think it was one of my favourite canned beers of 2015. Yeah, that milky chocolate with a little bit of dark berry. Oh, cheers. Medium body. Again, with that milky chocolate. Slight dark berry in the aftertaste. Slight, little bit. Sticky lips. Yeah, I'm feeling unpasteurized naturally. The 7% is well hidden. Is this beer totally awesome? For me, no. Is it a well made beer? You get that little bit of biscuity, bob and biscuit taste after the aftertaste. But I have to say that the Reliance for me, as well as the Smoky Horizon, is probably their best light and best dark beer. But yeah, it's nice to see that they've got inspirations from different aspects of life, like Star Wars. It moves and inspires many people across the world. But it's a nice beer. It just Do you know when it's just like, it's a nice body to it. But just near the end, it just falls apart a little bit for me. It starts out nice. It might be because of the, I've had it in the fridge for like 2 or 3 weeks. Get a little bit of tropical like taste in the aftertaste, but other than that, it's a nice beer and it's well made, can just like the rest of the Moor range. I don't think you can ever be disappointed with any of the canned range from Moor beers, but for me, the Reliance as well as the Smoky Horizon, which I mentioned, is the best light of that for me, personally. Final thoughts. Yeah, bourbon biscuits and milky chocolate. It's a nice beer. As far as my favourite Black IPA, no, I'm still a big fan of the Black Jesus from Great Egg, if you get a chance, try that. So, yeah, check out Trembling Madness. Thanks to Rob Davisheer for picking this up for me. You take care. Goodbye. Well, I should say it at least once. Totally. Awesome. The Force Awakens. You take care.